All right, ninth graders. Now we're at the point where you're filling out your course selection form. Okay, here are some really important things that you need to know about. All of our course descriptions, along with teachers have created course videos, are on our website. You can go to our course selection form website or our course catalog, and there are links to videos about the different classes and what to expect. So if you're not sure what to sign up for, or whether an honors or an AP class is the right choice for you, you can use these videos as resources. Another resource is your teacher recommendation email that you got on Tuesday, March 2nd. Your teachers have gone through and they know you, they know our classes, and they've gone through and they have given you some recommendations. So please view those and take those into consideration. All right, let's get started. First things first, we need a name. Make sure you put your name on the top of your paper. I am Kristen Langith and I am filling out my 10th grade course selection form. Note that this is due on March 12th. Make sure you get this whole process completed by March 12th. Okay, we are going to sign up for an English class. You have two choices. You have Honor Sophomore English or Sophomore English. We're going to sign up for a social studies class, either AP World History or Modern World History. Now, if you're not sure which class to sign up for, check out your teacher recommendation email that you received or watch the videos and view the course descriptions at the course catalog. My teacher recommended sophomore English. I think that's probably pretty accurate. I think that's a good fit for me. I'm going to sign up for that class. My social studies teacher recommended me for AP World History because I am a history buff. I love history. I like history. I like spending time on history. I'm pretty good at it. So my teacher recommended that I go into AP World History. I agree with that. I'm going to push myself in that area and take that AP class. Now, math, it's really important that you view that teacher recommendation form. We want you to go in order of math classes. Skipping math classes is not advisable, and you will be very lost if you do that. So the order of our classes goes Algebra 1, then Geometry, then Algebra 2, then Pre-Calculus. Please check out what your teacher has recommended and select the next class or the class your teacher recommended. I'm currently in Algebra 1, so I'm going to select Geometry. That is also what my teacher recommended, and I'm going to select Geometry. All right, science. You have a lot of choices for science over here. So check out your teacher recommendation. My teacher recommended Chemistry in the Living Earth, and that is the class I agree should be the class that I take. Okay, so we have selected 1, 2, 3, 4 credits. I'm going to put a 4 over here. 4.0 credits, which means to get to my magic number of 6, I need 2 more credits for my electives. Now, when you're considering your electives, you want to look at what classes you still need for graduation. Do you need CTE? Health and Fitness? Fine Arts? Do you need your World Language? So you can select classes that will help you reach that end goal of graduation. I haven't taken any CTE classes, and I know that's something I want to cross off my list this year. I think I want to go into education, maybe be a school counselor. So I'm going to select Careers in Education. That's a 1.0. So I have 4, I have my 1.0. I need one more credit or class, one more credit. So it could be 2 semester classes or 1 year-long class. All right, I think I'm going to also check off some of my fine arts requirements and I'm going to sign up for photography. That counts for CTE and fine arts. Note the asterisk. If you want to know what all those classes are, you can refer to the course catalog for the asterisk classes that count for more than one category. So that's a half a credit. I have one more half credit left, and I think I will go for pottery. I've seen some of the cool things that they make in that pottery class, and I want to do that as well. Okay, we have a total of 6 classes. That's our magic number. Now, if I can't get these elective choices, I need some alternates. Okay, so let's see. I am going to take store operations. That sounds interesting. How about computer assisted drafting or CAD and food science? I like to eat, so I'll do food science. I also like to cook, so that would be a good class, and that's a half a credit. All right. Just so my counselor has a lot of extra options to choose from, I'm going to put one more class here, and I'm going to pick leadership as my last backup. Now, it's important that your backups are different than your first choices, because if you can't get your first choices, it needs to pull from something different. Okay, now that you have 6 total credits and some backups, let's look at the bottom of this form. Because I chose to take an AP or an honors class, I picked AP World History, I need to read this statement to make sure that I know the commitment that I'm getting into by selecting an AP or honors class. In addition, I need to fill out this AP student agreement form. You can go to the website right here, print that form off, and I have done that. Here is my form. This gets turned in with your course selection sheet when you take a picture of that and upload it to your English Google Classroom assignment that will be due on March 12th. So I'm going to make sure that I know exactly what I'm getting myself into and that I'm ready and prepared for this AP class. I'm going to read the expectations. I'm going to sign my name, and I'm going to make sure my parent signs their name, and I'm going to turn that in. Okay, last thing, super important that everybody sign the bottom of their form here saying, yes, I agree, these are the classes I want to take, and that you've talked to your parents and they sign as well. This is something that we want you to take some time over the next week and a half and select classes that you find interesting, that challenge you, that are at the right level for your abilities, and that may require some conversations with parents, with teachers, with your counselor. So make sure you sign it at the end, and you are finished. On to the next step of entering it into PowerSchool.